Happy Half Hundred. That's what I call this. Happy Half Hundred. This is Game Lounge Podcast number 50. Good Lord. That's a big number.
Yeah, 50 weeks, almost a year.
50 weeks. We do this every week, podcast, where we BS, talk about things and stuff. And, yeah, it's gameplay. Let's talk about that, Mikey, because I was with you when this happened. I can't believe it.
Okay, and we got a couple people here with us real quick, though. We got Noah J. Yo. It's been a while, maybe it's been about 3 weeks or so. Mm-hmm. You've been busy, went to E3, found some secrets out.
He's Hollywood now. It's crazy.
Know, seriously.
Wait, you went to E3? You went to X Games?
Yeah, X Games, left straight from Austin, got a plane from there, went to LA, back home now.
Yeah, he's moving on up in the gaming world. Moving on up in the gaming world. And maybe
selling those quad feeds. Let's go.
Maybe found some secrets, some gaming secrets, maybe.
Maybe it. I don't know how much of it is secret anymore because it was kind of stuff that they were going to be revealing right after E3. So I'll see if any of the stuff I can pull up real quick is still secret. I'll share that.
And we got Sally Mew. How you doing?
Hi.
And Wintergore, how you doing?
Good evening.
And we gotta talk about this gameplay real quick. So Dosha, you're actually in here. You're actually playing Call of Duty Ghosts for once.
Yeah,
with me.
Man. And my gun was working at that round too. I can't believe it.
I'm so excited. We found a setup for Dosha that he likes that works for him.
Oh my god. What is it?
We can't see it in this gameplay. It's my point of view. I didn't actually have the best game. But we'll talk about that. But he was telling me you like single fire weapons.
Yeah, I can't do all that. Rat-a-tata bullshit. One shot, one kill. I played Ghost Recon and Rainbow Six for a long time, so you know my shot has to count. I can't spray.
Yeah, so they don't have one shot, one kill rifles in Ghosts, but there is the two shot kill, which is the MR28 something rather. I said put that on with
MR28,
the red dot.
Red dot. Everybody gets headshot. It's over.
Yeah.
And positive.
And you've been doing pretty good with it. And we ran into this clan, like OMA or OMA, I don't know what it was. And what happens in Call of Duty Ghosts is there's this thing called Clan Wars. And what happens is they make clans go out and pub stomp people, which is just public stomping. It's not even, it's called Clan Wars, but the reality is it's just a bunch of clans going out and randomly crushing people. That's what it is. What they need to have is a clan playlist and put all those sweaty nerds, dump them in there, and then they can all duke it out. Because right now, it's ridiculous. You got six people or nine people, whatever, and they go in there, and if they see another clan, they'll back out because they don't want no competition. So what happened was, it was me, Dosha, and then four random people from the stream or whatever. Mm-hmm. I mean, we're all right. We're all right. We're not like MLG pros or anything. You know, we went in there, we're having fun, and we start winning this domination. And what happens is when they start losing, they start pulling out all these explosives with danger close, which actually makes your explosives even more powerful. I'm like,
it didn't work.
So they resorted to that. And it became annoying, but it wasn't letting them win. And then when that didn't work, they just they bounced. That was it. It was a forfeit.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, but they had a luxury seat. See, but our team, we had an advantage, though. We had a great motivational speaker in Shadosha the Fly Guy. He let these people know that, you know what I'm saying? We had this discussion last week. He was like, listen, man, I got to show you guys the true art of cyberbullying. These guys are a clan. They think they're that good. Let me show you how to cyberbully in style. So we bullied them around. We moved them. They started blowing themselves up, and then they just quit. It was a great time. See?
Yeah. But normally, though, if you're a solo player, it is not fun playing on the weekends because that's when Clan Wars happened. And then like you just get wrecked by these clans who just don't want to play other clans. So I don't even know why they call Clan Wars. But anyways, that's what happened. That's the first gameplay. Another thing real quick, though, since we got Noah here, there's a new GTA money glitch. Did you guys hear about this? Or I talked about it.
Yeah. There's so many glitches all the time.
And what's funny about this new money glitch, Noah, I'm not sure if you posted this newest one, but there's one where you move a toolbox around. Have you seen that one?
Yeah, that's one I posted.
I lost some subscribers because I posted that, and they said that I'm part of the reason why the heists are being delayed.
I don't know about that one.
What do you think about that? I mean, you
gotta mute my.
So Noah, you're really hardcore in the GTA community. I mean, yeah. Allie, I know you guys play GTA too, but are we really ruining the
community? I think that's an excuse.
It's an excuse.
Fix your game.
I had people leaving comments. They said, F you, unsubscribe, dislike, peace out. Okay, fine. If you want to play Coveted over and over again, which, by the way, have you seen what they did to Coveted, which was previously a really good mission to do?
So hard now. It's ridiculous what they made it.
It's almost comical what they did. They just quadrupled the enemies now on Coveted. And what about Rooftop Rumble? They did make that a little bit tougher, too.
There's still a pretty good method for that one, but just overall, they keep making money harder and harder to come by, and just wondering why people keep creating money glitches over and over and over. Like, every single patch, they made it harder. Patch the missions that make easy money. Even though it's a grind, you're still making a decent amount of money, something you can actually buy stuff with. They patch all those, and they wonder why there's money glitches popping up here and there.
Yeah. It's been 9 months since the game's been out. There's still no heist. It'll probably be a year, right? Because I think they're probably going to release them when the... Well, this is my opinion. I think they won't come out until next gen.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I think so.
There's some leaks stuff that... I mean, again, leaks you have to take with a grain of salt, always. But there's some leaks stuff that says otherwise that... I don't know if you guys heard about the leaked Independence update, but word has it we might be seeing some heist related things with that.
Related keyword.
Well, related, yeah.
Well, the point is I think it's tough to get money, and if you don't have to do the glitch, you don't have to do it. You can play the same Rooftop Rumble over and over and over, and you could do that. That's fine if that's your idea of fun. Because there's no big way to make money. There are no heists online.
Or buy shark cards.
Oh, yeah. I keep forgetting about that. If you want to drop $20, $50, what's the biggest one? There's like a...
8 million.
Yeah. 8 million. What's that, like $60 or something?
Yeah.
If you want to drop $60 on fake money to enjoy the game, great. You can do that. But there's a lot of little kids out there, including myself, that we just can't afford it. And my mommy isn't going to give me a shark card. Okay?
And then you just get caught. You get caught cheating. You get thrown in the cheaters pool for 4 months, like almost 4 months. And then you contact Rockstar support. You're like, hey, man, I've been here for 4 months. And you guys said you were going to get me out. And they go, oh, I'm sorry. Here, let me give you $1 million in GTA money. And then they get you out. That's another way you can earn money.
Game Lounge exclusive.
Dunce hat, Noah.
But anyways, it was a small percentage, but still, man, when people make those comments, it stings, man. It hurts. So that's the two. There really isn't too much big gaming news. Although this is kind of big, it does affect all of us. Sort of. YouTube will pretty soon have 60 frames per second.
Ooh.
Finally, which is great for gaming. And a tip jar.
Doesn't oh,
wait, really? What?
Yeah.
You mean like donations?
Yeah, son. You could sign up for it.
Have you, oh my god.
You can
I'll have to check that out.
I know you're like YouTube money. That's all you're thinking.
I'm about to collect all the nickels, man.
I don't know how to copy those tips? I don't know how to copy this link. You guys can see.
Honest question though, let's be real for a second. How much of that is going to YouTube? You know, YouTube's not just gonna let you put on a donation button and not take a portion of it. It's just I don't see it happening.
Doesn't Twitch have something like that, or is that just people putting their own personal donation?
They put. I will on my channel. I have two options. I have the subscribe, which is through Twitch, and then I do have my own donation button. So if people want to donate, they can click it. If they want to subscribe, there's more benefit. Well, either way, I have my own personal benefits, but it's more visual benefits from subscribing because I have smiley faces that belong to me. Yeah, exactly. People like that stuff.
Man, PewDiePie's going to be... He's going to make so much extra money. Like, probably like 30, an extra 30K just in donations a month, I bet. From all his millions.
Oh, my God.
I don't know, but I think a lot of people could really use it because a lot of people watch the vids on mobile, and sometimes mobile doesn't show ads. People have ad block, things like that. So
apparently, improved annotations are coming in, and annotations on mobile as well.
Oh, wow.
Oh, yeah, I forgot to mention, because this came out recently. Speaking of annotations, Twitch has created kind of a YouTube annotation so that people know that you are live on Twitch. I think that's the best thing ever for somebody that's, like, you know, streaming and has a big YouTube following, because when they're watching your videos, it pops up on the bottom. This person's live. It's the best. I forgot
that
about
is awesome,
that.
Awesome, yeah.
All right, so we actually got a couple of things that involve viewers, right? Sally, we've got a contest thing going.
Yes, we do. So since it is number 50, and you guys wanted to know what's the big thing, we will have one of you guys come on to the podcast with us.
What?
Say what? Peanut butter jelly time, peanut butter jelly time.
But how? What they do? They just they just Skype you, or what they do?
No, you sell your soul. No, back up, dick. No. So basically, you guys have to have a YouTube channel. It doesn't have to be popping, but you guys need to make us a video, a commentating video. You guys don't have to put footage, but if you guys have, you know, a game for us to watch, that wouldn't make us, you know, fall asleep. And anyway, so basically we're, you know, determining it based on how you guys talk. And of course, in this video, introduce who you are and maybe talk about some topics you want to talk on the podcast, or even try to answer some of our old podcast viewer questions. And we'll be going through all these links by tweeting YouTube Dude, me, and Shadosha. Make sure you tweet all of us so we can all look at your video and discuss it, and we'll pick a winner in 2 weeks. So you guys have until 7/10/2014 to have this awesome opportunity to be on this podcast. And who knows, maybe we might even comment on your video.
So that's like, what, 2 weeks, pretty much? Mm-hmm.
Episode 52!
And ready for it. Do that have to be a certain age, or?
I don't think so.
Okay.
And just have a little bit of bass in your voice, just a little bit.
And does that be a certain length? Does that be HD?
Well, I think we're basing the quality of how you talk, and if you can have that, you know, personality spunk, that shine.
Keep it short and sweet. I mean, on average, a YouTube video, you know, retention on a YouTube video, the longest you'll go is 5 minutes, right? Nobody wants to go past 5 minutes. And again, we're judging your voice. You can sell yourself in 1:30. Okay, I've done reels before. I know how it works, so holler at your boy. But, yeah, I think anywhere from 1 minute to 5 minutes is fine. I ain't trying to watch a whole 10-minute episode as to why you think the word backup dicks is funny. That's, nah, son. Nah.
I learned something.
Oh, God.
I learned something. Boobs will reel people in, and like, you need something. If you don't have boobs, it's just something that'll like smack someone in the face and like, huh? And like gets their attention and wants them to keep going on. Because maybe we'll talk about this later. I started watching this new show, Orange is the New Black. Well, I know it's not brand new, but it's new to me. I watched the whole damn season like fucking last night.
And it's on Netflix, yeah,
and
man.
The first episode is titties everywhere. And I'm like, huh? Okay, let's watch this. And then and that's how they got me. They got me. And then every
and lesbians.
Yeah.
It's like Oz, so pretty much.
There's not too many lipstick lesbians in there. Anyways, and then I noticed that as the show went on, it got more funny, more serious, and the boob to footage ratio started going lower and lower and lower and lower. But by the time they eliminated all the titties, like, I was already into the show. See, if they started the show all serious, I probably would not have gave it a chance. But they hit me where it hurts, kind of like they're like, like that's
your kryptonite.
It was so overtly and unnecessarily sexual, episode 1 and 2. And anyone who's watched it, they know as more and more episodes went on, it got less and less ridiculous and more kind of serious, more about the relationships. So I'm not saying
from Oz porn to Sex in the City in prison.
It's cool. Do you guys all watch it?
I watch it.
Yep.
Winter has to watch it because I'm blasting it.
It's cool. I'm gonna watch season two. Probably go binge on that one. But
I heard it's not a bad show. I'm still trying to catch up with Game of Thrones and House of Cards.
Yes.
Behind. Okay. So yeah,
you gotta watch. Yeah, catch up on GOT.
Yeah. All I'm gonna say is you're gonna love season two because it was a mind fuck. That's all.
I love me a titty though. I might get into Orange Is the New Black just because of that.
Yeah, it's all right.
Can someone put that on a t-shirt? I love me a titty.
Okay. But the point is like if you're someone new to something, Twitch, YouTube, whatever, like you gotta kind of do something. Start with a bang. That was my whole point. Like they kicked off their thing with a bang, and it got me that initial. That was like the hook, line, and sinker right there. You know, and then. It has a good writer. The chick who wrote Weeds, if anyone remembers Weeds.
Yeah. It's right.
Kenji or Genji. She wrote it. Anyway, so yeah. She's good. But she knows, or I'm assuming it's a woman, but they know that that's how you get people in, you know, get them with the sex and the craziness, and then you can move on to serious stuff. So maybe that's how you can start your commentary. I know that's how I start mine. I try to start it with something relevant. Like
you're going to get so many people banned the first thing. It's like, shoot, I can't start the podcast without at least one titty. Damn. This is going to be great.
No,
this
like
is going to be a great 2 weeks.
Like I tell people, yeah, I do. I tell people and I do commentaries if it's, I'll have the title about something that's very relevant to what people are asking or want to know about. And so... Just saying, this Orange Is the New Black just really hit me recently because I don't think Game of Thrones started that way. It started kind of serious from the get go.
Yeah,
although,
they did have that huge incest sex scene in the first episode.
Yeah.
I forgot about that nasty shit.
I will say though, Game of Thrones already sort of had a very big fan base already, right? The books are like 15 years old or something like that.
Mm-hmm. They did.
All right, so anyways, we'll have links down below to all that stuff. And speaking of viewers, would you want to do that viewer thing where once a week they leave a comment?
Yes.
And we have some interesting ones. Do you want to start with a depressing one, or we have kind of a fun one, sort of, kind of fun?
Come on, let's bring the mood up. So let's start with depressing. Okay. Depressing first?
Huh, okay. Because I didn't pick that one. Who picked that one? Wasn't me.
I picked this one. Is it the first one?
Yeah.
All right, I'll read it. Captain... Suggles. I think he wants to put Snuggles, but Captain Suggles, Uncle's Bay. Uncle's Bay.
Suggles, Uncle's Bay. Yeah, okay. I got it.
I have a question. How do you feel about self-harm? I'm pretty sure this is about everybody, too. So, personally...
Well, I was just going to say, you made fun of his name, and so now he's going to slit himself.
Oh, no! Oh, my God!
Kidding! Kidding, he should know us by now. We've fucked around. Go ahead, Ali.
Well, you know, I have scratches on my arms, and people assume that I either slip myself or I have a cat. And usually I have a cat. But other than that, for reals, I don't like self-harm. Self-harm scares me, especially because I had an ex-boyfriend that used to hit himself a lot, and he'd hit himself until... I'd be like, okay, like, I'll cave in to whatever he liked. So, I don't know, self-harm can be, I don't know, just dangerous in general in my situation when I had experience about that. I don't know, it's just crazy. Huh. Like, did you guys ever have any crazy girlfriends that wanted their way or they're like, don't break up with me or else I'll hurt myself?
I don't think she's... I don't think she listens to this.
And this has been another episode in Mikey's closet.
I'm not sure if I mentioned her or not. It really wasn't a girlfriend. It was just a girl that I hung out with. And yeah, her left arm was completely wrecked. You would think like a tiger just went hamster on her left arm. Lots of cuts on her thigh and stuff. And it was a little... kind of disturbing when you first see it because the scars were pretty bad, but it was kind of weird and hard to understand, but like why people do that. And I don't know. It was kind of like, she would let me touch it and stuff. I thought it was kind of cool. That's not the right answer. That's what I thought at first. Because it was just like a bunch of lines and they were bumpy. And I'm like, oh, that feels kind of cool. But she didn't care. She would show them off. She'd show, not show them off, but she wore short things. You could see it. And I remember we're at a party. This isn't a girlfriend, more like a girl space friend. And we're just kind of having fun at a period in our lives. And I remember when everyone seen the cuts, it was like, whoa, everyone was just quiet. Because it's not very often you meet a serious cutter. But it's sort of a mental thing, and it releases endorphins, and it's kind of sort of like shock in a way. If anyone's ever been in an accident or hurt themselves, like when I was in a car wrecked and my left door caved in and hit me in the leg, and I was like sort of in shock from my car being totaled, and I was like, whoa. And I didn't feel any pain at that moment, because like you feel like this, your endorphins just boom, they just kick in. So I know that's why she did it. She just said it felt good at the time, and she didn't have very high self-worth. And what I think about it is, when you see people that do that, you just gotta be there for them and give them support and be nice. Like, kind of, sort of like the Elliot Rodgers guy. Like, mm-hmm. We said it before, like, if I ever encounter someone like that, I would, you know, try to be kind of in their life and be supportive, you know. I mean, I know hindsight is 20/20, and now it's too late to be Elliot Rodgers' friend, even though he was kind of creepy and weird. but I make an effort, you know, but I'll admit, it's easy to say that now that you know that he went bonkers and killed everyone, you know what I mean? Cutters aren't going to go out and kill people, they just kind of hurt themselves, but you gotta be nice and be supportive, and it's bad, don't do it. That's what I think. It didn't bother me, though.
What about you, Dosha?
Yeah, I was going to make a joke, but I'll hold it for later. Anyway, I have to agree with the statement that, you know, most of the time self-harm is usually done in the form of a cry for help, especially if they do wrist slitting and they wear short sleeves. Like, you want people to see that. You're obviously trying to showcase that something's wrong, and sometimes they can't find the words, so they harm themselves in order to get that attention. As a person who's gone through a stage of depression, I know how it feels to be at that low in that slump and not know what to say or how to communicate with people. I've never cut myself or hurt myself or anything like that, but I'm just talking about the overall frame of mind. It's easy to make regrettable decisions. So, you know, that's kind of where suicide comes from. Suicide is also another form of self-harm, no matter how you dice it. And yeah, and all of that stuff kind of stems from the same thing. So, you know, pay attention to people. Really pay attention to their mannerism, how they're acting and stuff like that. Because not all self-harm is in the physical sense. You know what I mean? They could be I always say sleep. You know, you always hear the reference, sleep is the cousin of death. If you notice people who just sleep all day and they don't really have any drive or motivation to do something, something might be wrong and they'd rather be dead, but they don't want to commit suicide, so they just sleep. It's the same damn thing. So, you know, so just pay attention to that. Yeah, that's all I got to say about that.
That, or they could be a hardcore gamer.
That too, yeah.
Oh my god. Yeah. What about you, Noah?
You guys said most of the stuff that I would agree with on the helping people side of it. So I guess I'll just take it from the other side of it. If you're feeling that way, then I guess just know that, like, there's better ways to deal with it than that. And there'll always be someone to talk to you. Even if you feel like there's no one you can talk to, there's always someone out there who you can talk to, like a teacher, friend, parent, whatever. If you don't have anyone close in your family, there's someone at your school or someone you know wants to help you, and they just don't know that you need help yet. So talk to whoever you need, and there's better ways to.
There's a website. I forgot the name of it. I'm trying to find my phone because I forgot the name of it. Anyway, there's a site where you can literally anonymously post if something's wrong or something's bothering, something's hurting you. You can anonymously post it, mm-hmm. and nobody will know your name. Nobody will see, and any random person will get it who's going through maybe the same thing or something like that. Or even better, you know what? If you guys are feeling that way, y'all know I gotta ask FM. Stop playing. Push that button. Ask me a question. I'm open to everything all the time. Please don't hurt yourself. There's people out there that do care about you and are willing to talk to you. I'm one of them. So do it. Game Lounge supports living. All right? God damn it.
Yeah. So, Captain Snuggles, don't catch yourself. Don't do that. All that's going to do, I mean, that is a cry for attention. Dosha, I kind of forgot to mention that. Yeah, that's probably why she did it. She's probably kind of showing them off. Hey, help me. You know?
Yeah.
So I was there for as long as I could. I mean, she's kind of... She was fun. She was a cool chick. What's kind of funny though, we stopped talking for like 2 years, and then we recently reconnected like a week ago.
Ooh,
yeah,
kind of something or nah?
No, she's fun. She's really cool. She's got a fucking crazy personality. So I don't know. Maybe she might want to come on and talk to you guys. She could tell you why she did that. I don't know, I have to talk to her about it first. But she's cool. She's really open and all that stuff. So, Captain, people are going to look at you weird when they see those scars, or you might end up with some kind of freak who finds them fun and cool and sexy and wants to touch them. So, but that's probably not going to, that'd be the, that, don't count on that. So are we done with the depressing thing?
The sad? Well, Winter, do you have anything to say about that?
Kind of. Sometimes you get people that would, well, I've obviously, like, I've heard of this before. I've watched a documentary in the UK because we're very, I don't know, we like very morbid things for documentaries in the UK. Well, I don't personally, but BBC seem to. And they've done ones where people would say harm themselves, and it wasn't specifically as for a cry for help. It was more that they enjoyed the attention that they got from people that were trying to help them, or like, say, if somebody did see and they're like, oh my God, are you okay? They enjoyed that kind of side of it. But wouldn't sad. Stop cutting themselves because they'd want other people to see it.
Oh my God.
Yeah, which is like, it's like that's the only attention they ever get from other people would be when they actually cut themselves. So they wouldn't stop doing it because if they stop doing it, people stop talking to them as much. And then they start doing it again.
Can so I make a recommendation to the people who want attention from an attention whore to an attention whore? Do what I do. Just be loud, obnoxious, and entertaining. There you go. Attention. Fuck.
Or run around in the street naked.
Or you could just be yourself and be cool, and that could work too.
Yeah, it works.
We're not like you, Mikey, okay? We're not all cool like you. I'm sorry.
Alright, anyways. So, are we ready to talk about the party dude?
Yeah, go.
Let's do it.
Alright, so there's this guy. His name's Finn. And he said he's going to a party in July, and it's his first party. He needs some extra help because he's only 14. He lives in England, and his brother is big, 6'3" rugby player, age 17, and he's small and very feeble, age 14, as he said. Any help would be fine. Thanks a lot, Finn. So it's his first party. He's 14. There'll probably be alcohol there, right?
Yeah, if his brother's 17, there'll be alcohol there. The legal drinking age is 18 in the UK, and, like, I mean, most people start at, like, 16, 17, so...
So, Winner, you're a fellow mate, and you've been 14 in England. So what...
I didn't drink at 14. I only started at around, like, 16-ish. Really.
Okay, that's good. So he should wait till he's 16, because there's going to be booze there. Anyone want... What should he do, guys? Anyone want to chime in? Help this kid. He said...
Well, he's going. He lost. He lost already. He's if one thing, he's definitely getting drunk. Because peer pressure sucks.
Mm.
And he's feeble. Do you know they always like to turn out the little feeble ones and make to see if they can get him to do dumb stuff. So, I mean, just pay attention.
Is that what happened to you?
Not. That's not the point. Listen. All right. So, what I would recommend is, first off, don't overthink it. Just enjoy yourself. Your brother's there. Your brother's got your back for the most. Hopefully, if he's bringing you, and just pay attention to the punch. If someone's standing around it too long, chances are they spiked it. If you're into that kind of thing, drink that shit. If not, you know what I'm saying? Just don't drink that shit. There you go.
Yeah, easier said than done. But I fell for it. I was like 15, and we had like Budweiser or some cans, and there's like a lot of girls there, and they were drinking. Like, I felt like I had to. Like, if you see a bunch of chicks drinking Budweiser, but like, I'm like, what the fuck? You're gonna look like a little bitch and not hold a beer? You know, I'm being serious, Dosha. What are you guys gonna do?
Don't be a little
like,
bitch.
I mean, that's a big deal. Like, looking back now, I probably would have waited. because that first beard will fuck you up. It feels weird. The first, I can remember the first time you drink, like, doesn't alcohol feel weird the first time? It really tears you up. Because, like, you're, like, kind of freaking, you're freaking out a little bit. Like, whoa, what's this doing, you know? Like, I don't know. I wouldn't have done it. So that's what I would tell them. Don't feel pressured. You don't have to. If you don't want to drink, don't do it. But 14 is kind of young. And he says he's small and feeble. So that means you're a lightweight. That means half a beer is going to rip you up.
Oh, just smelling it.
But we only touch on one side of the story, though. We're automatically assuming he's just going to get shit-faced when he gets there. And, I mean, there's more to it than that. Like, also, I was just going to say, since it never really says just alcohol, just don't be shy. Enjoy yourself. I don't know what y'all get into in high school nowadays, but wear a condom. I always say that. Don't get anybody pregnant. That's my motto on my stream. All right? You know what I'm saying? And, yeah, just, you know, enjoy yourself and just don't look like an idiot. Be naked out. And don't do like what Sally said and run around naked. That, nah.
Well, this is only if you want attention.
Fuck that shit. Vine exists. Nah, that should be on Vine in the evening. Nah, man, nah.
Yeah, hang around your bro. Hang around your bro. I will say, though, if you're the one person who's not holding on, like the very physical act of holding onto a drink, I don't know about you guys, but like if you're at a party and you're not holding on to something, don't you feel kind of weird?
Yeah.
It's private line.
Your hands.
for that, just have a glass of Coke or something, because then people can't really tell and just drink. And if you are drinking alcohol, like, this is a mistake I've made before. My brother's like, basically, he's built like a rugby player, so he's like 6 or 7 foot it roughly. And I made the mistake of trying to drink at the same pace that he did. And obviously him being a big bloke and like me being like obviously the smaller, like skinnier variety, I obviously got completely wasted when he was like only slightly tipsy. So like that, if you are drinking, I'd make sure not to drink at the same pace as like any of like the bigger ones or like maybe the heavy like party goers there.
I would say also make sure you're eating while you're drinking. Because if you drink on an empty stomach, that's really bad for you. Yeah. Don't forget about that.
Yeah. Yeah, I do that on purpose because you could save money on booze that way. You get fucked up. I drink and then I'll eat. Fuck that, because the food absorbs alcohol. That's counterproductive. That's my
goal. Holy shit, Mikey.
If I'm at a party and I'm trying to get fucked up, I'm going to pound the booze first and it'll rush to your head and then you enjoy your food.
No, but, Mikey.
Don't do that when you're starting out because you will get tore up. But Wintergore, that's a good idea. Like, if anything, go to the party and bring like a bunch of those red cups and bring some soda, and then people can't see what's in your drink, but you're holding on to something. You're holding on to a cup, and they don't know what it is, and you could be sipping on that.
Yeah, and a lot of the time at the parties, people like, well, in the UK, the most common drinks are things like vodka and Coke or cider. Cider is like, if it's a very cheap party, a lot of people drink like apple cider, like huge bottles of White Lightning, which are this super like supermarket cheap alcohol, basically, like kind of how you get really cheap beer in the US. And if you're going to drink, you can just bring like Coke along, because if people bring vodka, a lot of the time at parties, everybody runs out of like the sodas and they've just got these bottles of vodkas left. So you'll be the guy that like saved the party by actually having like extra soda with you. Kind of.
Yeah. I mean, the bottom line is don't feel pressured. I think 14 is kind of young, though. I mean, I know the age is, what is it again? It's 15. No, 18. I know the age is 18 to drink there, but I don't know.
Yeah. A lot of people drink, like, in houses and stuff a lot earlier than that. Yeah. So what if he's actually not talking about drinking and it's more of, like, a sense of what he should be doing at a party? Really, because if it's his first one that he's gone like going to at this kind of like teenager's age.
I was gonna say bring a friend that you can actually talk to, because most likely your big brother might just wander away and leave you alone, and you can be that awkward kid that just sits there the whole entire day and not talk to anybody and be like, yeah, great party, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, that's good. Bring a friend, because mm-hmm. your bro will go off and do his own thing.
Yeah.
If you are bringing friends and you bring girls, you need to notify the 17 and 18-year-old friends of your brothers that these girls are underage.
Yeah.
Put it into like, oh yeah, makeup all over, and they're like, "Hey, boys."
Yeah, please do that.
Yeah, girls learn early to live a lie. Their makeup's a lie. Their height is a lie with those damn high heels. Their boobs are a lie with the fucking bra. Everything's fake. Why can't we have some fake ass shit? We don't put crap on our face. We don't stuff our fucking pants. We don't do any of that fake shit. We're real. Anyway, so are we done with the party thing or nah?
I think so, but you know, just to make sure, just mingle and talk to people and network. Have fun.
Yeah.
Network. See, we're spoiled right there. See, I just said networked. We've been to too many social events, man.
Oh, yeah, just be chill, hold on to something, and whatever. Bring a friend, though. I would definitely do that, because your bro's going to go maybe hook up with a chick, go do his own thing, go out back and smoke some grass. Who knows? So you might be awkward. So hopefully there are friends there. Alrighty, what's the next thing?
Okay, iPhone Hex 311 says, I'm 14 and recently drank a lot of alcohol and had my first hangover. And woke up at 3 a.m. throwing up. How old were you when you first had a hangover and what was it like? Let's go to Noah first. Let's wake up Noah.
Okay, so first of all, this sounds like the same guy who just asked the previous question came back for the answer and just asked this one.
Noah.
So, I guess I'm the minority here that I don't actually drink or anything like that. So, I mean, I still go to parties, I still hang out. Again, whoever gave the advice about having something in your hand at parties is like really solid advice, because people don't bother you about if you don't want to drink, don't drink. But I guess that answers the question really. But I don't drink, so I guess I don't have a first time or a first hangover or anything like that. I'm shocked the crowd.
All right.
Wow, you are young, man. Jesus Christ.
Uh-oh, is he cutting out for anyone else?
For the earlier question, I tried to... Hello?
It was cutting out a little bit for me, but go ahead, go on.
Alright, yeah, well, the first time I had a hangover was because I tried to keep up with my brother, so we were hitting, like, triple vodkas, coke, that kind of stuff. I passed out outside of the nightclub, woke up in the taxi, remember throwing up and then waking up at home on the sofa, and, I think the main reason I had a hangover was because I didn't drink any like water or anything, any fluids. I didn't hydrate myself, and I just woke up and my head was killing me. Obviously, like nausea, dizziness. You feel sick for like pretty much the entire day. You can't eat anything. That kind of stuff for me. What about you, Mew?
I think it probably has to be in college. Well, earlier in college when I was a freshman, I went up to Boston University to go visit my friend. And she had a lot of frat guys there for some reason. And we were playing Wii games. Like, Wii bowling was the hottest shit at the time. And I just remember drinking so much. We were doing Jaeger bombs. I was actually, I think, 18 when I was drinking. and I don't know. All I know is through the night, I drank a lot, passed the fuck out. I woke up in the dorm rooms, and I was just puking and spewing everywhere because I pretty much just blacked out in the dorm room. And I just remember things being shuffled, like people coming in and out. I don't know. Just it was crazy. How about you, Shadosha?
All right. So, I was a victim of peer pressure. yes, it sucks. My ex, actually, she was big into partying and, bullshitting. And I'm not a clubber. I don't like clubs. I really don't like those kind of environments. And I don't really drink either. I mean, I have before. I know how to hold my liquor. But at the time, that was my first time ever drinking. So we went out. She got me drunk, brought me home, had her way with me. That was kind of cool. But she didn't, like, give me water or anything. And so I just woke up just chucking stuff. And then she wanted to go out because she had something to do that day. And it sucked. I was dreary. I was tired. I was beat, worn out, grumpy. You'd have thought I was on my period. It was nuts. That's it.
Hmm. Bunch of lightweights over here.
What about you, Mikey?
Here we go.
Well, you know, when you're younger, you just like it's like new to you, so you don't know your limits. So I've really only vomited a couple times, really, and that's when you mix booze and hard liquor. You're not supposed to do that. I mean, that's like That's like a number one thing. You don't do that. No, that's a no-no. But I didn't understand that. Liquor and booze, it'll mix, and then you'll throw up. But after that, that was pretty cool. You know, I always drank water before I went to bed, and I'd be fine. Except this one time, I got really shit-faced at my friend's house, and I kind of passed out on the lawn and did all kinds of stupid shit. And so I don't want to get into it right now.
Just passed out on the lawn.
Yeah, it's dumb. I don't like to get into that, but you drink. That's a big thing. Drink water. Drink water before you pass out, because that's kind of what a hangover is. You're dehydrated. That's what it is, really.
Yeah.
And people's bodies react to that dehydration differently, and you feel like crap. But so that's what that is. Some people, when people wake up drunk still, they think that's a hang. I guess that is a hangover, but they don't feel sick. They're just still kind of buzzed, you know. That's happened a couple times. That's been kind of annoying. That happened to me once, where I was at a party, and then I woke up the next day, and I was fucked up. And I'm like, dude, this is not fun, because it's like the morning.
Yeah.
And like, I felt fine, mm-hmm. but I was like seeing fucking double, and I was like, dude, this is annoying now. This isn't fun anymore. So that was kind of weird. That was very, very weird. So yeah. So ready to move on to something else?
Let's do it.
We have all kinds of weird stuff here. What's the thing about... Wait, did we already talk about League of LOL turning into a college sport? Who's that?
Yes, that's mine. I thought it was crazy that they are now offering college sponsorships, and it's athlete related, that these are college athlete sponsorship for all the, I think it was like certain specific universities like Arizona State, George Washington, Harvard. I think it's like the higher up colleges or universities that are there, the prestigious ones, and they're going to have competitive teams that compete against each other in university. I think that's crazy.
Well, so that sounds like it brings back the CGL and GGL. That's what that sounds like. I like that. That was awesome back in the day. They used to do that for a few games. Halo and Counter-Strike and StarCraft. They used to do that for. So now it's getting on a bigger scale. League. Ridiculous.
League isn't that big, though. They weren't at X Games like Call of Duty Ghosts.
If you would have seen the booth at X Games, it wasn't the most impressive of spectacles. It was the only air-conditioned place in the entire freaking 90-degree heat, but it was a pretty tiny little place. It wasn't that big.
You know where League was competing? They were in Paris. They were in London, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then they come back to California to go compete.
It was like stadiums with 10,000 people.
Yeah, they filled up the whole
Staples Center. That was nuts.
Wow. Oh, yeah, I heard about that.
Yeah. Well, how and come? Remember, people... Oh.
We're going?
I was
going
to say, people buy these tickets, and sometimes you only watch like one set of a match between two teams. And then they have to pay for the next set match to watch another team compete.
Hmm.
Isn't that really? Crazy? Mm-hmm.
What?
Yeah.
So why weren't they why weren't they at X Games, since that's a real esports? I'm sorry, but there was people saying Call of Duty Ghosts did not belong at X Games.
I was there. It was pretty... I don't want to say stupid, but it was pretty ridiculous walking past the mega ramp and having the Call of Duty match playing on the big screen next to that. I mean, I'm all for like competitive Call of Duty, competitive League, everything. It just wasn't the environment. The people weren't there. The booth was, there was a line to get in, but it only because it was so small. It really wasn't a big deal there. So, I don't know.
What other video games were there?
That was it.
That was it?
Ghost.
That's kind of odd. Hmm. Well, they had gold medals, and I think Optic won, right? They got the gold medal. They're gold medal champions now.
Yep.
Yeah, well, there's a lot of people that have kind of felt strongly. I mean, it's cool to see your favorite pro players, but I don't know, Ghosts. Anyways, we're not going to talk about that again. What's the next thing? I seen some sexy lesbian clothing.
That's not mine. Who is that?
That's Mikey.
Oh, shit. Yeah, that's mine. That's mine. Check it out. It's a Kickstarter.
Is it edible?
And they made their goal.
I'm pretty sure you can try eating it.
And these are some cool lesbians who they like to dress, you know, in suits. The thing is, men's suits are obviously made for men, and they don't have the curves that women have, the hips. And these are some cool fucking suits.
They and look fresh.
Look at these women, though. Can you scroll down and look at them? These chicks with the short hair and the side cuts and all that stuff.
Yeah, I'm feeling that hairstyle. That's...
How come straight girls don't have their hair like that? Why is it always gay girls? That's cool. I like that. That looks hot.
Because it probably doesn't feel feminine, or we, growing up, you just think long hair is sexy, I think. And then
be like Barbie and the Disney princesses.
Yeah, and then, you know, when you grow older, it seems to get cut shorter, because my mom's hair cut keeps going shorter and shorter.
Harder to maintain, yeah.
The thing that hit me about this, it's, well, one, it's cool that these girls are making their own custom suits, and they made their goal. But the other thing was, damn, I love their style. I like their suits and their short hair, but I'm just wondering, like, no straight girl's ever going to dress like that. I don't know, like, even, like, the collars. Like, they invented their own style of collars.
You know, actually, taking that back, that was actually kind of a style in, I want to say the 50s-ish. Sometimes you see some people kind of swap it out. Most modern example would be, like, if you guys have ever heard of the singer Janelle Monáe, she's straight as an arrow, but she wears this kind of style. A little more flamboyant, just because, you know, that's kind of how the electronic jazz era kind of works. But, she dresses some pretty dapper stuff, and she looked good with it. You know, suits and stuff with heels, which is kind of crazy. It's pretty awesome.
Yeah, it's really dapper. And even if you get a suit, they give you a flask. I don't know, it's just cool. And it's kind of... And just that girl, I see these chicks with the tats and the short hair. I'm like, those girls would never even fucking give me the time of day. They're not going
to... I think that's what sold it to you, the tats and the short hair. That's what I was... first thing I was thinking.
Christy Mack is kind of like that. She has the... I love you, Christy Mack. She posted a nice Instagram today.
I saw that. yep, that was pretty nice. Yeah, yeah.
I want to see her 1v1 Jen Seltzer.
He said 1v1.
IRL.
All right, what's the next thing? A gamer loses his fiance. Did a renovating his game room? What happened?
Oh!
That sounds horrible. Yeah.
No, this... What he did to his room is amazing looking. You gotta see it. Yo, his room looks fresh. The only problem is he just kind of... That wasn't his apartment. That was his girlfriend's. And he got a little obsessed. And just kind of like OD. But, yo, that is the man cave.
That is a man cave.
Oh, I see why you like it. He's got that fighter setup.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. He's got the whole spool.
Oh, damn. It's a 4-player setup.
Yeah, and Turtles in Time, man.
Wait, what? That's a Street Fighter logo at the bottom, though.
He's got a bunch of stuff, but there's no 4-player Street Fighter, though. So that's the Turtles in Time setup right there.
Oh, he's got Mike Tyson's Punch-Out, Donkey Kong. It's pretty cool. It's all right. And so what, she kicked him out? She didn't like it?
No, she left. That was her place, but she left. She said, whatever, I'm done. I can't do this. It was he became a bit obsessive about it. And Yeah,
you can't be, I don't know. I feel at this point, if gaming is such a big part of your life, you just kind of sort of have to date it. You have to date someone who's kind of a gamer.
Yeah. I mean, she contributed. She definitely, you know, helped out into it, but, you know, like I said, he got obsessed, then the neglect came in, and kind of forgot she was there because he was building this. By the time he was done, she was gone. It was, like I said, it was her place, too.
Yeah, it says that they initially began as a joint effort between him and his fiance, and however, the project became larger and larger, and it started to take over their lives.
Oh, I just realized the name. Chris Coloris. That dude's part of Twin Galaxies. I think he's one of the high scorers. Not a speedrunner, but tries to get those world records, so... that explains everything. I just noticed that. Oh, he's got a Twin Galaxy thing that I didn't even look at the picture.
But yeah.
Go ahead.
There's a difference between, you know, enjoying your hobby, but then neglecting life and probably your significant other. That would be bad because you need to put time into both. That's pretty much it.
Video game, Sally.
No, I told you, last live-in girlfriend I had, oh, she fucking hated gaming. Hated it, dreaded it. Well, yeah, pretty much, for the most part. Didn't understand it, didn't like it. And then after her, I dated this girl who, like, bought me stuff. Like, she bought me a fucking full-on Rock Band set and bought me other games and things like that. So, I don't know, at this point, I'd have to at least date some kind of geek or something. Dosha, I know you got out of something somewhat recently. What's your next role gonna be? Is she gonna be a gamer, or is she not even gonna be into that?
I gotta tell you about that situation too, cause
what happened? She's back in your life?
Yeah, that happened.
You made up? All right, that's good.
Yeah, I kind of forgot to mention that part, but yeah, no, we got back together.
When did this happen?
I'm gonna keep it all the way where I cut her off for like a good month, and she needed to just kind of sit and just, you know, like I said, I got things I got to do. I got to reevaluate my life. But I was just infatuated because she was such an addict to video games, or more so, she was more so into comic books and cosplay, but she was a gamer too. But overall, I mean, she contributed to the lifestyle that I like to live. She just acting nuts, but. All good. It's all love. So now we're doing good.
They're the best. Certain things.
Are you sure she's not crazy?
We'll find out. I haven't been still here. I haven't been.
I better not get any death threats or some shit.
No, you'll be okay. Me, on the other hand, I don't know, man. I've been playing a lot of I was playing a. What's the last game I was playing? A horror game, and she made sure to help me get scared as much as possible. So, you know, that's love right there, when she can make you piss yourself, right? The way I see it, you know?
No, that's good. Like, I can't get scared at stuff. I gotta get drunk first before I can get scared.
Yeah.
Like, out here in Cali, we got, like, the haunted ships, haunted, like, all the amusement parks, they turn haunted. They have the decorations up. They have ghouls, people that are in costumes, the haunted mazes.
Yeah, but those aren't well done. Cause see, people got to try to kill you. I've always said this. I was like, if a haunted house is gonna work, somebody needs to come really close to killing you. Like, if that doesn't happen, like, you need to be afraid for your life, like, genuinely. Cause,
I don't know what you're talking about. You obviously haven't went with the group of girls. They fucking freak the hell out and scream and grab onto you and act stupid.
I think that's the fun for them.
I'll admit, I have not. That's one I gotta try out. That's funny.
Have you been to a haunted maze?
I have, yes, couple.
Okay, I have. Don't the girls act stupid, though? Allie, don't you act dumb?
Sometimes. If it comes out of nowhere and I was not expecting it, I'm gonna freak the fuck out.
See?
Oh my god, a scarecrow, that's not gonna touch me.
I'll be like, ah! Like that.
Oh. No, but see, they have people that bang stuff when you walk by. They'll, like, bang the wall. Like, they'll do jump scares.
No, some shit's gotta fall on me. You know what I'm saying? For me to get scared, I gotta get hit with something.
No, they can't do that. They can't interact with you like that.
I know, that's what sucks about it. Like, that's why it's not scary to me.
So what I'm saying is, if I play a scary game or something, unfortunately, I gotta get a good buzz on.
But I still got to make a recommendation for you, because this game is good. You have to try, because I just played it, Among the Sleep. Even if it doesn't scare you, it's so well done, because you're legit playing from the perspective of a 2-year-old boy. That is the sickest concept. I've always imagined that. I've always dreamed. And it's an indie title, too, so it's kind of short. They executed it so well. It's ridiculous. I have gameplay in my... I'm probably going to upload it to YouTube, but I have it in my Twitch archive. It is so well done. And I'm not going to make any spoilers, but the monster's well done, too. It's ridiculous. I love that game.
Can I play it on Mac or nah?
You probably could. Like I said, it's an indie title, so it might work.
Or Dosha, you can be the first to tip Mikey towards his PC fund.
I could do that. You need to set that up now. All right? Let's do this.
I already applied. I'll have a link. You guys can click that link, and you can apply to getting a tip jar. Anyway, so we're rounding about an hour. What's everyone up to? Anyone want to say any what new stuff you're doing? Shows, games? What's going on with you? What do you got to pimp out? Dosha?
So, again, obviously, every day, 5 o'clock Eastern Time, live stream, I play what you guys want me to play. So, like I said, Among the Sleep, we just finished that. Apparently, they want me to go back to Nancy Drew, the point-and-click game. Yes, that game. Woo! So we're playing more Nancy Drew, and then after that, probably Dark Souls 2, and they also want to see me train in Virtual Fighter, so that's going on. And then a couple of days I may miss because I'm getting back into my entertainment industry-related stuff. Like, I'm doing a little more acting and, commercial crap, or at least trying to. So that's going to be happening. And then once I cut my nappy-ass hair, I'll be doing some more YouTube videos. So be on the lookout for all of those things. And also, again, don't forget the Ask FM. That thing has been going off, man. People have been asking real questions. And finally, not that much backup dick stuff. So, again, if... So, like I said, if anybody feels some type of way, if there's anything on their mind, anything they want to talk about, I'm very open to everything. All the fuck you, Sally, all the time. So just bug me. It's anonymous. You don't have to sign up for it. You can just type a question, ask me. I will answer it. Do that shit. And I'm not gay for pay. So.
Speaking of, what's up?
I hate this woman. That's all I said. Go ahead.
We've been talking about like a lot of gays and a lot of booze things. Speaking of all that stuff, I'm going to get into season 2 of Orange is the New Black. I really love that show. I always binge, like, Breaking Bad. I watched all 6 seasons, like, I think it took me a couple days. I was, like, zoned out. It was crazy. Ooh. Yeah, but it's 6 seasons. It took me, like, 3 days.
That's impressive, actually. Mm-hmm. Well done.
I play video games for a fucking living. I mean, that's not a real job. So I'm going to probably do that for Orange is the New Black. They only have 2 seasons. I'm into that. And we've been talking about a lot of alcohol. I'm sort of doing this little detox thing. And I gotta say, it was a little rough at first. So I haven't drank since June 15th. And then I'm not gonna drink all of next month. It's just this thing I gotta do. I do it like once a year, so I just go a month without any junk food and booze and putting crap in my body. And it was kind of scary because the first and second weekend, because I usually kind of drink every weekend, and I was like kind of craving it. I'm like, holy shit, am I like a fucking alcoholic? Because I was like, I wanted to drink. And then I realized, no, I was just bored. And I'm cool now. But it's going to be crazy because 4th of July is going to come and go, and I won't be drinking all of July. And then when I have a drink, one drink is going to fuck me up. So that's going to be crazy. So I'm doing that. Trying to be, you know, a little more healthy. So
I guess I can't recommend Angry Orchard to you because that's kind of been my thing. I don't like beers, but that Angry Orchard though is...
I will say though, I did have to have like a Rockstar drink. I had to have something. But
just drink green tea if you need caffeine or something, like some green kind tea? Of pick me up. Yeah, green tea is
there
fine.
A reason why you're doing a detox? You just want to become healthy?
You know what's funny is Melee's was supposed to, I mean, she's gonna be on pretty soon. I usually do it with her. Because we kind of do it around the same time. It's just good to do it. Just go a month or whatever. In this case, I'm doing it a month and a half of just not putting crap in your body. It's just... Mm-hmm. It's just... You just gotta take a break. And I felt like I was drinking too much. So... I mean, it wasn't like every day. It was every weekend. It was every weekend. And I'm like, okay, I gotta chill. That's too much. I mean, I know those people who drink every fucking day. I don't know. That's just how it was. I just wanted to do it. That's all. And I told Melee, and she's like, no, I'm going to get fucked up because I got a party coming up. And I'm like, oh, okay, fine. Then you do your thing. But it was kind of funny because when she would do it, I usually have her as a support thing. Like, I don't know, like when you do things like that, it kind of feels good when you have someone else doing the thing with you. like the diet thing or the exercise thing or the whatever goal you're doing thing.
So they can feel your pain too.
Yeah. I mean, but like I said, I'm fine now, but that first and second weekend, I'm like, damn. And I went to, and I was at the store the other, or not the other day, but a couple weeks ago, and I was like, damn, I could just buy a drink right now and no one's going to stop me because I'm a fucking adult. But I was like, dude, no, what the fuck? Like that freaked me out. That honestly freaked me out that I had a craving. I'm like, oh, that's like an alcoholic thing. So I'm like, fuck it. I'm going to go a month and a half instead of a month. Anyway, so what are you guys up to, Mew?
I actually got to finish Sniper Elite?
Sniper Elite version.
Sniper Elite.
Yeah, that was a really fun game.
I had fun watching you guys die, by the way. Just gonna put that out there.
Right. Fuck you. But it's an awesome game on PC. If you guys want to snipe a lot, slow-mo is awesome, and there's like x-ray slow-mo. It occurs more often if you play by yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Multiplayer wasn't as fun because everybody was fucking camping. Because everybody's a sniper. And you can sound whore the crap out of that fucking map or all the maps. And I played also Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare that just came out recently.
Oh yeah, on PC. And that, I mean, I played it on Xbox One and the game was awesome. And on PC, obviously, it's just as good. So we've been playing the co-op and also the multiplayer. Mm-hmm. But you've only played one of the modes. And I tried two of the other modes today, which are like kind of like very objective based, and they were like a hell of a lot of fun.
Other than that, I've been catching up on anime, which I really recommend. No Game, No Life. It's so good. And if you guys love video games and also Sword Art Online. So that's my 2 cents, what I've been doing.
Co-op must be nice. Allie, I was gonna ask you, I seen this anime slash cosplay thing. I don't know what anime it is or what the fuck, but there's this girl character that just has like a damn ammo pack as her damn bikini. You know what I'm talking about? The costume is ridiculous. It's like literally her little tiny micro bikini is ammo packs. You know what I'm talking about?
No.
But oh, she's called Nuni? Nuni or Nunu? It's Nuni or not? I don't know. I'll have to.
I gotta Google it. Hold up.
It's like Nuni or Nuni or Nono or. The cosplay was ridiculous. I was like, damn. And some girl dressed up as it at some WonderCon, whatever. I'm like, damn, girl. I'm like, the creators of this, they have to make these animes knowing girls are going to dress up like this. I can't think of any other reason why they would do that.
Well, cosplay and also, like, conventions, people tend to, it gives you, or Halloween gives you an excuse to dress up however you want to. Not, I mean, I don't care how people dress up. I mean, as long as they're staying true to the character. So, I don't know. I don't mind as long as they're, I don't know, cosplaying it because that's how the character looks like. There are some people who do cosplay like something, but they make it a little bit more skankier, which I think is a little bit weird. But hey, to each
I like reimaginings, but I can't stand that. Like, if you're gonna slutify it, that's one thing. But you know, I kind of wish they would just stick to. I don't mind reimaginings. Like, one of the biggest trends is like, you know, gender bending certain characters. Like, how many female Links do you see at a convention, right? Everyone wants to be the female Link or female Master Chief or something like that, right? That's like, I'm just naming gaming conventions, but, you know, like, I see that all the time.
Mm-hmm.
I'm okay with that, but if you're just gonna do a female version so you can show your tits, you just go to this New York City and wear nothing. Just show your tits that way.
Instead. Topless.
Yeah, there you go.
Noah, what you been up to?
I've been pretty relaxed since E3 and everything. I have a little list here of some of the games I saw and some of the games that I would say keep an eye out for 2014, 2015. Some of these are some later releases. Some of them don't even have release dates yet. But these are just my recommendations out of all the games that were at E3. These are the ones that I would recommend to everyone watching to keep an eye on and definitely check out. Dying Light, Destiny, Advanced Warfare, Evolve, Star Wars Battlefront, Far Cry 4, Assassin's Creed Unity, Halo 5, and Rainbow Six Siege above all else. If you like shooters, keep your eye on Rainbow Six Siege and check out the gameplay if you haven't already. That was probably my pick for the best looking game at E3.
I am a Rainbow Six junkie. That's the only reason why I even tolerate Ubisoft, because of Rainbow Six. If you do any videos, call me. I will pull out my Glock. All right? I will bring that Glock out. They don't know about the Glock from Vegas. That gun sucked. I was so good with it. Let's go. Single shot Glocks, headshots?
No, if you guys haven't seen the gameplay of it, check out the gameplay from E3. It's just like one little mission. It's like it's alpha gameplay, and I wasn't supposed to see any gameplay of it. I didn't have an appointment with Ubisoft, but I may have like been just around the corner and watching in through the little gap in the tent, and I saw some... some secret stuff going on the game, and they were just showing some more stuff to the big industry guys in there, and this is like pre-alpha gameplay, and it looks better than any shooter that I've played in a long time. Keep your eye on Rainbow Six Siege. That's all I have to say for E3.
I found something, but it's not the one, but look at that. Is that cosplay? That's just a bitch in some bikini. How is that damn cosplay?
That research, though. You're still doing that science,
I know.
Huh?
How about this one? This one is crazier.
Oh, I know her!
Kill la Kill.
Oh,
people have cosplayed her.
Oh, what's
Yoko? You said Kill la Kill.
She's related. What is this from?
Kill la Kill anime.
Yeah. Okay, who's the other character in there?
Oh, God, I don't remember her name.
Kill la Kill. It's No, here it is. There she is.
Show us.
We should have guessed Kill la Kill in the first.
It doesn't say
wearing no clothes. It should have been.
I was gonna say Kill la Kill, which is really interesting. I forgot which convention the girl had to leave the convention because they didn't. They were like, it's too revealing because it was under boob. As opposed to over, like, exposing your cleavage, that under boob was more revealing, which I thought was interesting. Because it's like, I don't know, side boob, top boob.
No, but you know, under tit is so, oh my God, that under
boob. No, that's what I'm saying, under boob.
I love your under tit. Oh, shit.
Oh, God.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh, my God, they're all perverts.
It's so perky. It's just.
I like how Noah's silent.
There, who is that?
I'm researching right now.
Who? Okay, that character. Who is that?
Can that be the new hashtag? Can we drop? Just put hashtag undertit now? Can we just get rid of backup dicks?
Watch Kill la Kill, you guys. It's really random as fuck, but really violent, but awesome. Mike, you should watch it.
It's underage recommended hentai. You can't do that, man. It's not
okay, look at that outfit. There's girls that dress up like that.
Oh my God.
Kill la Kill non...
Yeah, that's the nudist beach uniform.
No non cosplay.
Oh, and it's shaved. Oh, shit.
Oh, my. Look at this.
Yo. Oh, yo. Yo. End the podcast. End it.
Wait. Look at this.
That you guys been dying for.
Can't do it. Can't. Nah, man.
Look at this latest one. Look at this.
Flip the table with this erection. I got to do my mic.
Why would an artist create this character in an anime other than to see a woman girl dressed up in
look
this?
At all that titty!
Because it's attractive to people, I guess.
Where the less there's actually a relevancy to wearing less of the clothing. Like, you know, when MMOs make all these skimpy girls and it's like, they wouldn't have good stats in this. It's like, you're more powerful for having less clothes on.
Too much Terra, that's what it is, Winnegore. You play too much Terra. That's exactly how it was in Terra. It's like, alright, I have this level 1 armor, I'm fully suited, I'm level 60, I'm wearing a fucking string. Like, really? Really? Oh, Lord. Can we end the pod? I gotta do something about this.
Can I do something about that?
Yosha, here's a box and tissues.
I need lotion or at least peanut butter. Fudge.
You can borrow it from Noah.
Yeah, I got you.
Peanut butter, Noah. Good luck.
All right, so guess that's going to wrap it up. We had a good talk, and we're going to sit here and fap to all these creepy anime pictures, and... Some of these things are ridiculous. I'll put a link to them, but look at your own risk. These anime artists, they're damn perverts.
Bye, guys.
All right, see you guys. Bye.
Bye.